what a shame.
Damn, life is a mother. It's hard to sit back and see the same thing that happened to me happen to you.
This ain't love, but here's the thought I wanna get it
done.
Daughter's taking a nap. I just wanted to share a little bit with you guys about our day yesterday. Some of you probably wonder, does Denny ever get out of the house? As a matter of fact, I do. Yesterday, I had a great day with my daughter. Out of the fact that she was actually very pleasant to be around yesterday. She didn't disobey me too much. she was just all around just very pleasant. I think she enjoyed getting out too, and just, you know, hanging out with mommy, getting out of the house. But before I get started, how do you like my shirt? It says Lady of Leisure. Anyways, first we had to go to the library. She loves going to the library, getting a new book. Mommy cannot get away with tucking her into bed without a story. I started that because it was encouraged, and I don't regret it at all. She loves books as much as mommy does now, so we go for mommy and for her. And then, while we were at the library, though, I did have, since I got my new computer, I got away from reading some of my books and kind of lost track of time with turning in some books. So I had some late fees to take care of. Wasn't a lot, really. Maybe about $5 or something. And so we got that taken care of over at the library. And then right next to it, or like across the street to it, about 3 weeks ago, they opened up a little shop called the Java Roasting Company. A little bitty place, a little coffee shop, and I was thinking when I saw the sign before they had opened up, I'm like, oh, cool, you know, right next to my other love of, you know, library books, they're going to have a coffee shop. Those are my two things. I love coffee shops, and I love bookstores and libraries and stuff. So we went over there across the street, and at first I opened up the wrong door, and there was a bookstore there. It was a African American bookstore, but I did find a couple, about three books that I liked, and she gave me 10%. Gave me 10% off because I was buying three of them. They're all by the same author, and she said that if I, you know, y'all might have remembered in previous videos, I mentioned about the Forgiven Ain't Forgotten, and I compared it to Madea's movies, Diary of a Mad Black Woman. And one I recently seen, actually, since I made that video, I could also compare it to that. I Can Do Bad All By Myself. A lot of Christian themes, but at the same time, a lot of un-Christ-like characters mixed in. Very inspirational. And she says, well, if you like that book, you'll like hers, too. So I went ahead and bought all three of them. And so that's when we went next door. After the bookstore, we went next door to the little Java place. It was just a little bitty place. Had maybe three little tables there. Really little. But there, they had a mixture of different kinds of coffees there. Smoothies, tea, they look like they even have a little section too where they'll have a little bit of sections of ice cream. What we ended up getting, I got the white chocolate mocha cappuccino and a cappuccino chocolate chip muffin. And the muffin was handmade, and the cinnamon roll my daughter picked out was handmade. She picked out everything herself. She got the cinnamon roll and a little thing of orange juice. She was very smart about her choices. And the prices were really reasonable. I think we spent $9 on all four items. And I'm like, okay, I could deal with that, you know. I was really proud of her. And she sat right down at the table while my mommy paid for it. And she got right down to eating it. And when she got through, and she's like, well, mommy, I'm full. You know, we just wrapped it up and put it in her backpack where I had my books. And then our next trip, our next step was going over to, and I had promised her that we would go to McDonald's, where they're supposed to have AT&T Wi-Fi. And you can usually, you know, where the hotspots are, you can pay for, you know, one-time use or whatever. It's like $3 and something. And luckily I brought my Cricket because it wasn't working. For some reason, the screen wasn't coming up. It just wasn't working. And I had checked the locations, and I'd even asked one of the employees there, and they said, yeah, they do have Wi-Fi. But it wasn't coming up on my screen. It was saying not available and all this. So I was like, wow, okay. But my daughter did get what I promised her, and that would go over there, and she'd get to go play at the play equipment and go play with the other kids and things like that and do something different, you know. It's actually been kind of cold over here still, and when she's at home, you know, to go play out in the backyard, she really hasn't had anybody to play with a whole lot. Most of the kids here in the neighborhood are older, and they're in school and things like that during the day. So I figured that would be a treat for her to go and play with some other kids and go do something different. And so we had a great day. We really did. I didn't get to do what I needed to do at the bank. I thought the bank would be open an hour later than it was. So by the time we got there, it was closed. And so for the most part, other than the library, the going to the coffee and the bookstore and McDonald's, we ended up spending most of the day riding the city bus. I just wished, you know, that it didn't take so long to get from one place to the other on those city buses, but it does. And for that, it just seems so discouraging, and the motivation to getting out of the house, it's hard for me. Because not only is getting ready, but then trying to catch the bus on time. And, you know, if it's cold, especially when it's been cold lately, to stand out there with her complaining about how cold it is and everything, it's just like, it doesn't feel like it's worth it. You know, I just assume stay home. But you can only do that for so long, especially with a four-year-old. I think that's part of the reason she's been so difficult and so destructive. She's getting bored. So, I just wanted to share that with you guys, what we did. And if you're ever in Little Rock, check out the little store there. It's next to the Williams Library. And they just opened up about 3 weeks ago. I know that the Java coffee shop did, so. Well, thanks for listening, you guys. I hope y'all are having a blessed day, and I will see you guys soon.